again. Peabody here. Sherman, what does the word Sphinx make you think of?
Skunk?
Oh, dear. Never mind. Today we are going to Egypt to witness the true story behind the building of the first great pyramid. Getting right down to the business at hand, I instructed Sherman to set the way back for the year 3000 B.C. and the place, Giza, on the border of the Libyan desert. Needless to say, the way back responded beautifully, slammed into high gear, and in less than an instant, we were standing inside the palace of Cheops, second king of the fourth dynasty. However, it appeared as though we had arrived at a rather bad time.
By the beard of the sacred flamingo, I won't have it!
I beg your pardon, Your Highness, but what seems to be the trouble?
My mustache! That is what's the trouble!
Mustache? But you don't have a mustache!
I do over there!
He directed our eyes to a huge painting of himself on the far side of the room that covered the entire wall. Sure enough, it had a large black mustache on it.
It took 300 slaves 2 years to paint that magnificent picture of me. Then he comes along and puts a mustache on it.
And whom, might I ask, is he?
The evil Prince Ahmed Fez.
Is he your arch enemy?
Yes, and he is also just 5 years old. If he wasn't my nephew, I'd...
His words were cut short by a large pimento cream pie full in the face. This little beast, I take it, is Prince Ahmed Fez?
The third.
Gosh, you mean there were two more like him? Ouch!
Ooh, that Ahmed! I'll feed him to the camels. I'll...
Sire, you must remember he's only a child. Perhaps if...
Perhaps nothing. This time I will build a swimming pool shaped like King Farouk. It will be the biggest swimming pool in the world. I'd like to see him wreck that.
He can't paint a mustache on it either. But poor Cheops is still on the wrong track, Mr. Peabody.
Construction began immediately, and in what even I consider record time, the pool was completed.
It's done. This pool will go down in history as a great wonder of the world.
I'm sorry, sire, but I'm afraid it's about to go up in the air as another failure. It seemed as if dear little Prince Ahmed had obtained some gunpowder on a recent trip to China, and this gave me a brilliant idea.
It's no use. I give up.
No need for that, sire. I have a plan.
Mr. Peabody always has a plan, Your Highness. Why, one time he...
Never mind, Sherman. I'll give him an autographed copy of my memoirs before we leave. I took a pencil and some papyrus and quickly drew some very complicated plans.
What is this?
It is the monument you are going to build to yourself, a pyramid.
Pyramid? Say, I like this idea. But what about Prince Ahmed?
You leave him to me. Just make certain the pyramid is constructed exactly as I have indicated. Every slave in the kingdom was called to the task. Huge stones were quarried, shaved to the precise size, and rolled into position. 40 days and 30 nights later, the project was complete.
Beautiful. Wonderful.
Mr. Peabody, I never thought I'd live to see the day.
What day is that, Chairman?
The day you would make a mistake. Look, you designed the pyramid upside down. It's standing on its point.
I'm surprised at you, Chairman. That is the most perfectly precogitated part of my plan. Remember, Ahmed the Terrible is still lurking about with his gunpowder and... there he is now, right on schedule. Inasmuch as I had designed the monument with this in mind, the pyramid was not damaged a bit. It simply flew into the air, turned over 3.5 times, and then... settled to earth in its proper position.
Perfect! Oh, Mr. Peabody, can you ever forgive me for doubting your velocity?
I suppose so, Sherman, but that is veracity. At this point, the problem was solved. The world now had one of its 7 wonders.
What about Prince Ahmed? Won't he cause more trouble?
Not when you consider the pyramid is 481 feet high and there is a fine, spanking breeze at the top. You see, Sherman, I managed to get to the seat of most any problem.
Gee, it was sure nice of King Cheops to invite us to dinner, Mr. Peabody. Yum. This is delicious. I wonder what it is.
It's just something else His Highness is famous for. In fact, this particular dish was named after him.
You don't mean...
That's right, Sherman. Lamb Cheops.